In this video, we are going to learn about image formation due to convex lens. See, already we have discussed about the ray rules and everything, no? In this video, image formation due to convex lens. Coming to the first case, here, when the object is at infinity. See, object is at infinity in the sense, we don't know where the object is. Object is very far from the lens. So, this is the convex lens, no? So, object is very far away from the lens. So, what we have to do at that time? So, we will draw some parallel rays here. See, these two are parallel rays which are parallel to principal axis. So, these two are also parallel rays which are parallel to principal axis. So, the rays which are parallel to principal axis will pass through the focus. So, this is the focus. So, all these rays are passing through this focus. So, at that time, the image is formed at this focus, F1 in the sense focus, and the characteristics of images are, the image will be the real image, inverted image and highly diminished. Why? Because here this is the point image, so this is the highly diminished image. And coming to the second case, when the object is beyond C2, see, this is the second case. Here, optical center F2, C2 and F1, C1, no? So, object is beyond C2. So, when the object is beyond C2, two rays will consider here. A ray will parallel to principal axis that will pass through focus. And another ray which is passing through this optical center will go undeviated. So, these two refracted rays are meeting at this point. So, the image will form here. That means, image is forming between F1 and C1. So, this is F1 and C1, no? Here the image is forming. Here the image is real image, inverted image, and it will be diminished image. Diminished in the sense that image will be smaller than the object. This is the object size and this is the image size. So, the image is smaller than the object. Then coming to the third case, when the object is at C2. Here the object is at C2. That means it's exactly at center of curvature. When the object is exactly at center of curvature, so two rays we are considering. A ray parallel to principal axis will pass through the focus. A ray which is passing through the optical center will go undeviated. So these two rays are meeting here exactly at C1. That means when the object is at C2, the image will be at C1. Both are C only, center of curvature. So at this time, the image will be the real image, it is inverted image, same size. Here, the object size will be equal to the image size. The image will be the equal size of the object and it is formed at C1. And coming to the fourth case, when the object is between C2 and F2, here the object is exactly between this C2 and F2. So, when the object is between C2 and F2, two rays we are considering. A ray which is parallel to principal axis will pass through focus. A ray which is passing through the optical center will go undeviated. So, these two rays are meeting here. So, this is our image. So, the image is formed beyond C1. And here, the image is real image. It is inverted also. Whenever the real image comes, it will be inverted image also. And enlarged image. That means, the size of image is much more grander than the size of the object. So, enlarged image and it is formed beyond the C1. It is formed beyond the C1. And coming to the fourth case, when the object is at F2. Now, exactly the object is at F2 here. So, two rays we are considering. A ray parallel to principal axis will pass through this focus. A ray is passing through the optical center will go undeviated. So, if you consider these two rays are parallel rays. These two rays are not meeting at anywhere. So, we consider that when the object is at focus, the image will be at infinity. See, if you consider the first case, so that is opposite for this. Here, object is at infinity, image is at F1. Here, image is at focus and, object is at focus and here, image is at infinity. Here, we will get a real image, inverted image, enlarged image and it is formed at infinity. That means you may get a doubt. Infinity, how we can justify the image? So basing upon the previous case, we will consider this real inverted now. So here also we are considering real inverted and enlarged, and this is formed at infinity. And coming to the fourth case, when the object is between F2 and O, here the object is between F2 and O. So this is our object here. So two rays we are considering, a ray parallel to principal axis will pass through this focus, and another ray is passing through this optical center. It goes undeviated. So these two rays are also not meeting. And here what we'll do is, we'll extend these two rays, these two refracted rays are extended back. So definitely they will meet at one point. So at that point the image will be formed. That means here a virtual image is formed. Image is virtual. If it is virtual, definitely it will be erect also. Virtual image, erect image, it is highly enlarged. If you compare the size of the image, the size of the image will be much more greater than the object. So highly enlarged, and it is formed at the same side of object. Wherever the object is, image also will be at that side only. So this is about all our six cases which involve in this convex lens.